Welcome to Naples, Italy, guys. Here in the south of Italy, there's a market over here known as Mercato Torretto. And I see it just up ahead, where they sell local farmer products, but the restaurants there cook with these products. So that's what we're gonna go check out, some extremely fresh and local prepared food. By the way, this is probably Europe's most crazy soccer town. Or football, we gotta call it football over here. The whole city is decorated and dedicated to the team here in Napoli. And Maradona,
he's a god.
I overlooked the entrance, guys. This is the entrance to the place. I could look in at all the football stuff. So it's an indoor market, guys. Kind of a farmer's market. Okay, I thought that was about to be a fight. I was hoping for it. Anyway, guys, I'm looking for a particular place called Nonna Anna, which is the place that gets all the local goods and they prepare food with it. Alright, I see it. It's incredible how they're obsessed here with the football team. I mean, they're going to win the local championship this year. There's no doubt about that. But overall, I mean, Maradona played here at least 20 years ago. He's still a god here. That means God right there.
You got to give it to him. He changed his team around. He got some respect on Napoli.
Anyway, this is the famous place over here. Hello.
Hello.
This is the famous Nonna?
I did.
Nonna here? Hello. It's closed?
Okay.
Italiano è pochitico. Pochito italiano.
No, che è importante però. Anzi è importante un napoletano, non l'italiano.
Okay.
È importante un napoletano.
All right.
So I gotta learn some Italian, guys. They're opening at 12, so we got 30 minutes to go. And then we're gonna go in there, guys. It seems like the place to be. What's up, brother? Buongiorno. All right, guys, Alejandro, what do you think? You're the vegetable food specialist.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. I love all.
You know all of these? So yeah, guys, they have a lot of fresh products over here, guys. One of the most popular is the artichokes.
You'd be surprised, almost everything on the menus here in Napoli have artichokes on them, and they sell them all over the streets.
Video, yes.
Ah, ma pure a me mi fatto video.
Video, YouTube.
Pure a me?
Yes.
YouTube?
Yes, YouTube. Making a video of this place.
Sai chi mi ha messo su Vogue Italia?
Italia?
Su Vogue Italia.
Su Vogue?
San Mioni.
All right. Okay. No, I don't know.
You don't know.
No, I don't know. I don't know. All right. All right, guys. So while we're waiting, I decided to come back on. Let's try the local beer over here. Let's try. Look, that says indiscutiblemente italiana.
That means it's Italian. There's no doubts about it. A Peroni.
Peroni.
Bionda.
Ebbene.
Hey, go.
Bene. Hey. All right.
Ben avanti.
Okay. Do you have the to open this, ma'am? Please. Where is it?
Wait. Here.
Okay, here it is. All right. Here, Alejandro, you can open it. Please.
Mamma mia.
All right, guys, they're setting up all types of foods over there. All right, I love her. You don't want to try it? He's like, nah, I can't have this for breakfast. I'm the crazy one. Nice and solid, guys, nice and solid. Peroni, 100% Italian. Dal produttore al consumatore. That means from the producer to the consumer. Are you guys? I met a Latin American brother from another mother.
Hermano, ¿cómo te llamas?
Alex.
Alex.
El impredecible.
El impredecible, eh. Put a song on it. So eres del Salvador, ¿no?
Yo soy salvadoreño, sí, gracias.
Okay, Dios, estás trabajando aquí en la Nona Ana.
Se llama el negocio Chivicote Nona.
Chivicote Nona, okay.
En italiano.
Chivicote Nona. Y hermano, entonces yo le entendí que aquí este lugar es muy popular, usan los ingredientes aquí, todas las verduras las sacan de acá y preparan ahí sus cosas y que se llena así. ¿Es así?
Sí, gracias a Dios, sí, fíjense que acá, de aquí depende de todo, digamos, lo que es el comercio. Cada negocio da la fruta, o la verdura mejor dicho, y pues, una, digamos, un día lo da un negocio y lo preparamos, ¿verdad? De hecho, pues iniciamos a trabajar a las 8 de la mañana. Y
o sea, empiezan aquí a las 8 y abren a las 12, preparando todo.
Lo más fuerte es a las 12 del día, que vienen todas las personas acá a comer. Y pues gracias a Dios es un negocio bendecido. Veo yo que se llena.
Claro.
Y pues, pero esa es la comida napolitana.
Napolitana, o sea, que es comida local, local.
Sí, es local, digamos, es como lo nacional de Italia.
De
digamos,
Italia aquí.
O como lo especial, porque esto casi son, digamos, como negocios diferentes que hacen la comida.
Ajá.
Porque lo más, digamos, es la pasta, ¿verdad? Que se
conoce sí, acá. La pizza. Y...
Sí. Gracias a Dios, como le menciono, pues, yo acá veo que sí se vende bastante.
Vale.
Y vienen muchos turistas extranjeros, hablan también el italiano, el español, y he tenido el conocimiento de hablar con muchas personas y yo les pregunto, ¿dónde son? Mira, nosotros somos de tal lugar.
Ah, bueno.
He conocido personas de Honduras, de Nicaragua, de Colombia.
De todas partes del mundo.
De sí, gracias a Dios, pues aquí interactuamos. Cada día es diferente porque uno conoce diferentes personas porque no vienen...
Claro, claro.
Así que gracias a Dios, pues, bien bonito porque me gusta este trabajo.
Está bien, estamos en un buen lugar. Pues bueno, ya van a abrir 5 minuticos y ahí nos vemos, pues, a ver.
Pues yo los invito a que degusten el plato.
Vale, pues.
Sí, sí.
Muchas gracias, brother.
Ok, ok.
So that is the Lola, guys.
She has passed away, but the restaurant still remains in family hands, guys.
And check this out, you got the volcano here erupted ages ago. I got Napoli in the house, guys. Napoli, the football team is everywhere. Look, they got a push on La Nona there watching over Napoli. You ready to eat? You hungry?
Yeah.
Always hungry.
Yeah.
She wakes up hungry. Anyways, guys, so the way it works here is they prepared everything already. You order what you want, and then you pay later. So let's check it out, guys.
Hello, buongiorno. Buongiorno.
Lasagna.
Lasagna? The best?
La mandare, la gente è l'infornata, non va che sa più il
baciamento. The lasagna? Number one here, that's the best.
Very good.
Very good, alright.
Alright, he's saying he comes here for lasagna. I see trades on lasagna.
So imagine that is what we try. Okay, so this is Italian food, Italian cuisine.
Okay, pasta e patate, con provola.
Pasta, patate con provola.
Pasta e fagioli.
Fagioli, pasta, pasta.
Pasta e ceci.
Pasta e ceci. And what is the best? Lasagna is number one here.
Lasagna.
This is the, okay.
Pasta forno, questa.
This
pasta,
is
pasta
the best plate here,
pasta.
Number one.
Pasta.
All right. That's what I'm gonna try.
Pasta forno, lasagna.
Oh, okay, yeah. All right. Lasagna, more lasagna.
More lasagna.
Okay. Okay, bene, bene.
Bene, bene, boom, boom.
Woo! Okay, okay.
Guys, it smells phenomenal. Okay, grazie, grazie.
Alejandro, we gotta try the lasagna here. Lasagna. All right. And maybe this octopus. It looks very interesting. They literally just opened, guys, and you see all these little to-go containers. Those are the orders that people placed earlier. I don't know when, because I've been here waiting, but maybe they call over the phone or something, but all old school, everything's on paper. They have them all prepped up. Holy smokes, guys, the place just opened. It's gonna get packed any minute. I'm here early. I'm gonna try the lasagna and let's see, I don't know. I gotta try something else for the vlog. Two lasagnas. Let's surprise Alejandro. One lasagna. And then my lasagna. Normally I like going to street food places and I prefer to vlog those places, but this place, I guarantee I'm not missing a beat. I feel like a street food is where the flavor is or the locals are eating, but this place, guys, I don't need to say anything else, guys. Just have Italians lining up. All right. Buon appetito.
Grazie.
Buon appetito. All the way from El Salvador. The safest country in the world now. Con el sabor de la nona.
Honestly, I'm so excited.
You're excited? Alright. I'm so excited. I know. Buon appetit.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, she went in anyway. Caliente. ¿Qué dijiste?
Dios.
Oh. ¿Eso es bueno o malo?
Es buenísimo.
Del 1 al 10, ¿qué le da la lasaña? Bueno, ahora te pregunto.
Sigue probando and then I'm gonna come back. It's my turn to try it, guys. I smelled that lasagna and I wanna try la lasagna de la nona Ana. Smells great. It smells fantastic. That is some of the best lasagna I've ever had. This ricotta cheese on there is just excellent. You got some ham in there. The pasta cooked perfect in the tomato sauce. Just like a good pizza needs amazing tomato sauce to just make it that extra special, that extra good. So does a good lasagna. And this guy here is not missing a beat. For me, it's one of the best I've ever had. I just had one bite. It's confirmed. Another peroni.
Del 1 al 10, ¿qué le da? Un 10.
I love lasagna.
Yeah.
¿Sigue transmitiendo en vivo?
No, estamos en vivo.
Quiero decir, es
pero grabando. Después lo edito y lo subo.
Ah, ok, de acuerdo. Lo importante es que está grabando.
Sí. Alright, guys, I'm gonna finish the lasagna. And. Oye, hermano, una pregunta. ¿Te has probado esta lasagna?
Sí, buenísimo.
¿Y qué piensas? ¿Te gusta?
A mí me gusta, o sea, casi la mayoría de personas, digamos, llegaron bien del platillo, que sí, por eso. Esta es la parte de los veces también. Mira, aquí todo un platillo, prácticamente la persona lo degusta. Muchos vienen por unos de lejos.
Sí, no, y veo que tienen, apenas abrió, ya tienen como 20 órdenes listas para la gente que la venga a buscar. Y...
Sí. No, y digamos, yo pienso que lo que en este arte culinario, lo que más predomina es lo bueno, porque es que todo lo mismo es bueno. Pero lo importante es la esencial, darle el toque, el toque del chef, como se dice, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Porque si uno, si solo pone a hacer algo y no le da el toque,
claro,
uno, realmente una persona viene un día, vez día no regresa. Pero aquí viene, muchas personas.
Sí, está bien.
Regresan, sí.
Vale, pues, gracias. Alrighty, guys. I gotta go to Salvador. Once one of the most dangerous countries in the world now, one of the safest. They pretty much just locked up all the gang members in jail. And yeah, that happened. I gotta go check it out. Oh, lasagna and a peroni. Mamma mia. It was that good.
Basta, pastor. Okay.
I had to try that octopus. Grazie, grazie. So I get the octopus, the pasta with the beans. How special to hear. And I'm gonna try their meatball out. Okay, thank you, brother. Thank you.
Enjoy.
Let's prepare the lasagna with the octopus. Let's get the octopus over here. Julian! octopus!
Octopus! That was good.
Alright. Let's go. Esta es la especialidad de la casa, una de ellas. La pasta con frijoles.
And then the meatball, guys. Oh my god, but that lasagna, I could eat like 5 lasagnas. It's that good.
Alright. We have a neighbor now.
Let's go. Let's continue the food vlog. The food expedition.
How's the octopus?
No lo he probado.
Algo que no te esperaba.
No sé, no soy fan del octopus, pero pero está bueno.
¿Está bueno?
Sí. Súper suave.
Oh.
I'm a big fan of octopus and that. I'm chewing on it effortlessly. There's a lot of fresh seafood in Naples, a lot of fresh fish markets. Just bring local fresh fish early in the morning. And you taste these black olives.
Las aceitunas negras las pruebas bastante.
Sí,
su presencia ahí.
Tiene un sabor fuerte.
Mm-hmm.
That's a strong taste. Due to those black olives, but I'm totally digging it. I want to try it with the black olives. So here's the holy grail, by guys. The olive, the tomato, and a big octopus leg. Let's do it. That was very strong. The whole olive changed things up. Yeah, I prefer just pick out the octopus alone. Delicious octopus. This is your wine, or they sell here?
My God, I order.
Oh, you order here.
You want?
Look how. Okay. All right, house wine.
House wine, red wine.
Red wine. Cheers, brother. Cheers.
Cheers.
Alrighty, guys.
You're a food blogger.
Travel blogger, food blogger.
Travel blogger.
Little bit of everything. Parties, football, everything's included. Oh, it's delicious. Now, what do you think about the lasagna? It's really,
it's
really
good. It's good lasagna.
It's perfect lasagna over here.
Perfect with meat.
Everything.
Yeah.
It is the lasagna to try. Oh, and the house wine here is excellent. I'm guessing they make it themselves. That bottle just
looks like they bottled it.
Right.
This is the second thing they said to must try, the pasta with the beans. Got some veggies in there. But it's all about the house touch. I'm curious how this is gonna taste, being that I see absolutely no animal protein in there. Not even the slightest hint of it to just give those flavors that things such as beef, chicken, and pork tend to do. Mm. The pasta's cooked really well, I like that. It's not a dish that blows your taste buds out of the ballpark, but it's just something solidly good. It tastes like something that mom will make at home. Definitely. Let's see what Mrs. Alejandro has to say.
Your torno. Sabe bien casero, en mi opinión.
Para mí es como una sopa con granos y pasta.
Exactamente.
Pero está bueno.
I'm gonna try the meatball. Buon appetito.
La buena.
Che carne.
That's a meatball like no other.
Es una mezcla de cerdo y carne de res.
Es muy blanca.
Uh-huh. Y tiene un sabor. Nunca he probado una albóndiga frita así.
Como. Es muy buena, pero no sé. Siento como un sabor que tiene algo más. Como un grano o algo, ¿sabes?
It has something going on in there. Nonetheless, it's a delicious fried meatball. ¿Ah?
Creo que es huevo.
Huevo.
Ahora les pregunto.
I don't know what it has in there, but I like it. This is gonna be the last dish. I just wanna try everything because everything is so good. This basically has cream, cheese, mozzarella, which is also cheese, but that's what the chef says, like cheese and then mozzarella and ham. So it's almost like a carbonara. But I'm gonna give Alejandro all the credit in the world. Her taste buds are on another level. I asked, what is in the meatball? He said, there's meat, there's pork, there's pepper, some herbs, and there's egg. She pointed out the egg. She's just...
Bravo, bravo!
I don't know, she's just a picky eater and she cooks too, so she knows about taste. Her mom has a market and they sell herbs, fruits, spice, all this stuff, so yeah, her taste buds are really low. But this right here, I love white pastas, and this is just, it's cheesy. It has cheese, a lot of cheese. It's so rich. Oh Lord, you gotta try this. You gotta try this. You have to try this. With the hand cut ham.
Mm.
Yeah, she's digging that one. You know, you feel like you're eating at a restaurant, obviously the food is that good, but it has that home touch. And it's what makes the difference in this place, guys. Everybody knows each other, it's just friendly vibes here in Napoli. Probably my favorite city in Italy. Oh, Lord.
What do you think?
Really good. Really, really good.
Yeah.
I like it.
Amigo! Amigo! Bene, bene, bene la comida. Thank you, thank you. Grazie mille. Grazie mille. Hasta luego, bro. Hasta luego, placer.
Guys, time to head out of here, guys. So, let's find out how much it is. Basically, you order all your food and then
you go over here to the counter.
And you tell her what you had, what you ate, and you pay like that. So,
hey, pleasure meeting you, brother. Buon appetito. Take care, brother.
Right, I'm very curious to how much everything costs. Thank you, brother. I'm curious. I don't even know how to tell her what I had. This is gonna be interesting.
So check it out, guys. It's completely old school. I don't see. Oh, they actually have credit card readers. But everything is written there.
Alright, it's official. This is my favorite city in Italy.
Absolutely love it.
I don't remember what the names of the dishes are other than the lasagna and the meatball. Okay.
Okay.
A pagare.
Che paga lui?
Lasagna dos.
Ah,
oh, you need to help us, brother.
I give you the ticket, okay?
Oh, you have the ticket?
I just write everything.
Okay, all right, he got it. All right, perfect. Everything was delicious. Bene, bene, bene. All right, he's gonna
get the ticket, yeah. Bene, bene, todo bene, bene.
Okay.
Guys, all right, there's the ticket.
Dos cervezas.
Due lasagne, una besciamella,
un
polpo, una polpetta, una pasta e fagioli, da bere, drink.
Dos peronis e un acqua.
Acqua piccola, small.
Acqua, small. Small acqua.
Bread?
Huh?
Bread, pane?
No, bread no.
Mangio senza pane, tu.
I love her. ¿Cuánto es?
38.
Okay. Card.
No, pagarme en contando que hoy dobbiamo pagare I lavoratori.
Okay, so solo efectivo.
Okay, grazie.
All right, so the card machine wasn't working. So you must pay the water? Huh?
Today.
Oh, today's not working. Okay.
This is a dollar and some change.
Grazie.
No, grazie a te, grazie a te.
Grazie a te,
grazie.
Grazie.
Grazie. Grazie. Grazie.
Thank you.
Thank you, bye-bye.
Thank you, bye-bye.
Alrighty, guys. Wow, what a place. If you come to Napoli, you have to come here. So everything was 38 euros. We had two lasagnas, the white cream cheesy noodles, the bean noodles, the meatball, two beers. Everything pretty much cost like 8 euros or something like that. Alejandro, what are your thoughts on this dining experience here in Napoli?
I like it. I have to say, when I was a child, the lasagna was my favorite food. So I was like,
oh, now you have
so happy, yeah.
You had lasagna in Italy now.
This will be the second best.
The second best lasagna you ever had?
Yep.
Oh, wow. What's the best?
My grandmother's.
La nonna, la nonna. I think grandmother's nonna in Italian.
Yeah.
Alrighty, guys. I got a little bambino in my belly right now after all that food. But it was finger licking good, guys. Delicious food. They use a lot of ingredients from here. And, well, you can taste it. And it's the atmosphere in there, guys. It almost feels like a street food place because of the atmosphere, people talking, and bam, bam, all this, all the action, the flavors is all there. And that was phenomenal, guys. We're back outside. You definitely have to come here. What is it called? Mercato Toretto. Toretto. I like the name. Right there. No, it's Toretta. Toretta.
It's Toretta. Or Mercato Municipale.
You put Mercato Toretta on maps, then you're going to get that. Alrighty, guys. The whole city is like this.
They're obsessed with this football team.
And Maradona is a god here. May he rest in peace. Look, I'm going to end the vlog here on this little... This part over here is really nicely decorated. Whew. You know, beyond soccer, beyond football, this team represents a lot to the city. And what Maradona did here back in the day revolutionized this city. It put Napoli on the map, so that's why they're grateful. And they love him, and él es un dios aquí.